long been interested in the life of scientists, especially astronomers. We tend to honor them in terms of their established scientific credentials, but in fact, they all were deeply spiritual people. I'm interested in the scientist as the dreamer, the scientist as the poet.
Regarded as one of the most important composers of our time, legendary minimalist Philip Glass brings his newest opera, Kepler, in a concert staging to BAM.
The best way of working with these kinds of people is to find their own words. And that's what we did with Kepler. Most of the texts are things that he wrote. I describe him as the man with his feet in the mud and his head in the clouds.
Glass's hypnotic score expresses Kepler's struggle to reconcile scientific discovery with the divine.
He was as interested in astrology as he was in astronomy. The most interesting people are the ones who have articulated that extremes of their personality. He had an enemies list of all the people he hated. We set it to music. At the same time, this is the same man who would talk about the movement of the planets. I mean, how could he be involved with such banal antagonisms? At the same time, his mind was living in such an elevated place.